Hello everyone, Jan here. Today I'll show you how smooth and productive it is to teach a dispensing pat on a plastic box cover with a UR5E when using the OneStick D control stick for cobots. The application consists of dispensing glue on a cover that has multiple radius dimensions along the pat. For this, the robot will be equipped with a dispenser along with a smart shift tool changer. Although this is not the subject of this video, using a tool changer allows automatic switching from the dispenser to a gripper, which will replace the finished part with a new one. As for the cover, it will be mounted and aligned with a robot base feature, but keep in mind that any feature can be used. Before we start programming, I will measure all different radiuses. In this case, we have two different radius dimensions along the path. Small radiuses have 3 millimeters, and large ones have 17 millimeters. Okay, let's start programming the application by adding two OMove nodes to the new program. This will allow me to add waypoints and create a path by simply clicking on the OneStick B button. Before adding waypoints, I recommend that you configure the move nodes. The first move will be used to record the approach and retraction waypoints. Be sure to select your tool TCP, in this case HE Dispenser 40. The second OMove will be used to record a dispensing sequence. To get a constant dispensing speed, I will use a move P, select the TCP HE Dispenser 40, change the speed to 25 millimeters per second, and modify the default blend with radius to 3 millimeters. The first waypoint that I will record are the approach waypoint to the cover. We will begin by positioning the robot directly on any straight line of the cover's glue pad. Using the joystick mode for the last motion will avoid popping a protective stop when the dispenser's tip will touch the cover. Then I will click once on the OneStick A button because this process needs to have 1 millimeter between the dispenser's tip and the cover. For the exiting sequence, we will copy and paste the approach OMove and reverse the execution order of all waypoints. This will link the exiting waypoints to the approach waypoints and allow a single modification to affect both program sections. Let's go back to the final approach waypoint and add two waypoints very close to each other to ensure the glue will overlap a little. We are now ready to teach the dispensing pat. For this, I will be using the joystick snap mode, which will allow dynamic speed control of the robot while following a perfectly straight line. Since we work with move P, all curves will be processed by the robot at execution time, and only intersection corners need to be taught. For the larger radius sections, I will also only record the intersection but change the blend with radius to 17 millimeters. Once all intersections have been recorded, confirm that your program runs at low speed. If there is any modification to do on any specific waypoint, simply pause on it, use the OneStick to reposition the robot, and hit the Set Waypoint button on the interface to update that particular waypoint. Finalize your program, change the move P speed setting according to your process and add nodes for starting and stopping the dispensing unit. Here it goes. We successfully recorded a dispensing pad with multiple radiuses in less than 10 minutes with the help of the OneStick. Thanks for watching. And remember, OneStick is designed for integrators, but ready for first timers. You have any application to suggest or need to discuss how the OneStick can help your business? Please send us an email at onestick@stickabot.com or visit us at www.stickabot.com.